Hello viewers, today we have Mercedes GL in our garage with a complaint of air suspension failure. So I'm going to hook up the diagnostic tool and we're going to see what is the problem of this car. This is the malfunction light for the air suspension that we are getting. So I'm going to connect to the car and we're going to go in the air suspension to see what is the error code that we are getting. Right now the suspension is running only on sport mode. The complaint is that the car cannot go in comfort or other modes of the air suspension. Okay, GL. This model is 164. Okay, let's find the air suspension control unit. Chassis Airmatic. So let's see the fault codes. And we have some fault codes for the right front solenoid valve for the front damping valve unit. This valve should be for the front shocks. So let's try to see some guidance that the program can give us. Okay, no help here. Okay, so this is the bot code that this car is getting. That's why the air suspension is in limp mode. It's only in sport mode because this valve on a front right shock has some problem. Now we're going to go there. I'm going to remove the tire and going to remove the dust cover, because when you remove the dust cover you're going to unveil the cables for the both valves, and we're going to continue from there. So I removed the front right wheel, the dust cover, only the front part of it, and that directly unveils the both valves that we are talking about, which are these ones, and this is the wiring for the valves itself. So I checked, I made a visual inspection on the wires and everything, but now I'm going to disconnect this plug and we are just going to measure resistance between the three pins that are in the plug itself. So as you can see, this is the shock. Up there is the strut, the air strut, and we are just checking the continuity between the three pins of these two valves that we have error codes. Okay, so once again, this is the plug for the both valves. Hope you can see there are three pins inside. So I'm going to use my leads for testing them. I don't want for the pins to touching itself, because this is going to give me false reading. So I'm going to start with these two pins here. Now I'm going to take my multimeter. So when I touch the both leads, we have a short. So now I'm going to try to read the continuity between the two wires. And we have open circuit on these two pins. Now I'm going to change one of the pins. I'm going to place it on the middle one, like that. Now, so we have one pin in the middle. We have three combinations in total on which we can read continuity resistance. So once again, on the other combination, we have open circuit. It's hard to see from my fingers, but I'm touching the ends of the cable with my leads of the multimeter, and we have open circuit. And now I'm going to do the last combination. This end of this pin is going on the other side. The green one is staying on the in the middle. So like that. Once again, one in the middle and the other cable in the other end. Let's see once again for a continuity, for a yes resistance. And once again, we have open circuit. As you can see, open circuit on the on all the pins. So let's see now what we're going to do. So we know we have something wrong on the right side, but we know we have no problem on the left side. That's why I decided to remove the tire and the dust cover on this side to show you for reference what resistance should we read on the three pins. So now I'm going to once again disconnect. Let me trace the wire. Yes, this is the plug once again. I'm going to disconnect it. And we're going to once again measure the resistance between the three pins. Once again, we have three combinations, and we're going to see what resistance we should get on a known good one. Okay, so once again, I'm going to use my... This actually leads are from PC. They are very handy for these small pins that some valves and sensors are using for testing. They are perfect. So the first combination. So okay, let's measure the resistance between the these two pins. After that, we're going to see the other ones. So this one and this one, and we have around 12 ohms of resistance between these two pins. So now I'm going to move one of the pins in the middle like that. Hope you can see what I'm doing. Probably not, but we're still going to continue trying. So once again, here we have once again 12 ohms of resistance, roughly, maybe 11. And the last combination. This is the third combination. Once again, we have three combinations in total that we can do. Let's see what resistance we are going to get like that. And this time we have 22, not 12, 22. And the pins that I'm measuring right now is between, just 1 second, I was measuring between pin number 3 and pin number 2. There was 22 resistance between these two pins, and between 1 and 2 we have 12. So for sure we have some problem with the right side. For sure we have problem with the both valves. As we saw, guys, we don't have any resistance on the three pins. Doesn't matter the combination. Okay, after checking the left shock, the left valve of the shock, now the right one is removed, and I'm going to try to do a little dissection on these two valves, especially the electrical part, because as we saw, guys, we don't have any continuity between the two valves. Probably we have three pins here because we have one shared ground and two power supplies for each valve here. I'm going to try to open this part and we're going to see each valve, does they have continuity here directly inside this chamber, because we can have a faulty wiring to the two valves here. So this is the two pins for one of the valves. We have the same cover on the other side, which I'm now going to remove. So it looks like someone is already been here, because as you can see, guys, this was has some signs of damage and it feels pretty tight here. Probably I'm going to damage it too, because this shock is actually remanufactured. It's a rebuilt one. As you can see, it's painted, but they didn't change the both valves. So probably they just removed them and placed them to the new shock. Not sure, are they checked them or something else? And this unveils the other valve. So now let's take the multimeter and check for the continuity between the pins directly here. Okay, so I set up the multimeter to continuity. This is the cable that is attaching to the original wiring of the car. Let's remove it from here and let's see, are we getting some continuity between the two valves. Okay, I'm touching directly the pins. And as we can see, we have 20 ohms. So probably this one is okay. Let's see the other one. Are you guys seeing what I'm seeing? Okay, let's place it here. Like that, I think it's better. Let's check the other one. And this one has 20 ohms. So both valves should be okay. I can't supply ground and power here to check them, are they clicking. But probably we have some problem with this wiring. Right away I can't see the problem. I'm going to check it out. Yeah. Probably, not sure you guys can hear, I see it. We have some intrusion here. So yeah, the wires are broken here. Doesn't matter, for the sake of test, I'm going to supply here a power and ground to hear how strong they are clicking. Okay, so I hook the two leads to a positive and negative, and now I'm going to try to touch the both valves and see are they clicking or not. Not sure, guys, you can hear it. But this one is working. Let's try the other one. This one is clicking too. So nothing wrong with the two valves. I'm just going to repair the wiring. Which one? Where was broken?
Okay.
So I'm just going to repair this wiring
and we're going to see, are we finally going to have continuity between the pins? Okay guys, so I repaired the wires. Actually the wires was like on the IBS sensors. I think they're something like with aluminium and they're pretty hard to be soldered. But with enough heat and flux, I was able to solder them. So now I'm going to reconnect the wiring to the both valves. And we're going to see how we have the specification resistance between the two valves now with the repaired wiring. So once again I'm going to use my leads. The pins are really small guys and it's hard to show you what I'm doing, but trust me, I'm connecting them. And now let's see what we're going to have. And as we can see, we have 12 ohms. So I'm going to rotate the pins and going to check for the other valve. Okay, this one, this was probably the shared power between the two valves, that's why we have 22 ohms. And the last combination, we should have 12 ohms. And voila. So this was the problem, these broken wires. As we can see, right now we have the specification resistance on the both valves. So now we're going to mount back the shock in the place and we're going to see with diagnostic tool are the error codes going to disappear and so on. Let's see what we're going to see on the diagnostic tool. I already hooked up the started diagnosis and now let's go in the air suspension control unit and see is this going to fix the suspension or not. Sorry for the glare, but hope you're going to be able to see what I'm doing. I'm just going to try to connect to the air suspension control unit and going to check if the fault codes are now able to be cleared. This is GL X164. Okay, let's go control units. This is why I'm using Conch, because it's 10 times faster than this start diagnosis. So, fault codes. And what you're going to say guys, the fault codes are stored, which means right now they are not current, which means I'm going to be able to clear them out. Let's recheck and as we can see no fault codes present. So this is a fix guys, just three broken wires. As you saw, the valves were okay and most of the times they don't break. So I think this is going to be for this car. I just need to reassemble the interior parts of this car and this is going to be ready to be shipped. So thanks for watching guys and see you in the next video.